came up here the other day and tried to get permission just to use the field. Nobody wants to let us use their football field, and that's so strange. Like as if we're gonna hurt the football field worse than the football players do. You know? Like yesterday, we went to this park to practice, and we didn't have our bus drivers with us, so we had to shuttle the corps in cars and vans, and it took over an hour just to get everybody over there. It's just the time factor. We waste a lot of time, you know.
Drum Corps International is composed of the top 25 corps in world-class competition and the all-girl champions. This afternoon, the judges will have their last look at this year's performances. For months, the individual corps have practiced and competed again and again to perform their routines with machine-like precision. Spirit of Atlanta, like the dozens of other contestants, is anxious to make it all pay off in today's preliminary round of competition.
Everything is going really good right now. We've been trying. Our goal this year was to break into the top three, and that's very possible at this point. That's we're looking at a top three spot. Anywhere in the top three. Well, drum corps is that way. It's happened before that the corps that hadn't won all year long came out and won right at the end. It's happened before. I think everybody's got that in the back of their mind.
A drum corps' performance is composed of various skills and their execution. Corps are judged in how well they march and maneuver, as well as their musical performances. Each corps has its own particular forte.
Spirit has strong all the way around, especially horns. Each person out on the field in all the top corps has the capacity to go out and play a show over and beyond anything that they've ever done before. So it's all relative when you get to the finals.
Timing is a critical part of the drum corps' performance. Each show must run no more than 13 minutes, no less than 11 and a half minutes.
But you didn't go overtime, or did it?
No.
But awful line was slow.
Yeah, it was.
That's not the main thing there.
But you didn't pick up the end of the show. You know the place where we said put four?
Mm-hmm. Did it not?
Nine.
I thought that the gun went off. But that's a little early. The
gun went off exactly where it should.
It just dragged on.
Yeah, the exit was a little slowing from the front end. That's why we've got 13. Exactly.
It'll work. It'll work. We'll get it tonight.
I'm glad we got the execution people off the field, but I almost had a heart attack.
Okay.
You know, one more second and it would have been 2/10. Okay, why don't you get them to attention and let them go to rest so we can give out the... Tell them to stay in their places so we can give them their pass back into the show.
Torkin, hut!
Yes.
Relax in place.
Definitely.
With the first hurdle behind, Corps members are ready for some relaxation, but conscious of the fact that the big event is still ahead.
I enjoyed prelims a lot. They were real nice. The scores were really high, which is what we expected. I was surprised by the Crossman score. I would never believe that they would get ever that low. On Spirit's first tour, we had a lot of problems with our buses, and Crossman had a lot of problems with our buses, and since we were both doing the same shows and on the same tour, most of the time we could help each other out. Like, they had a flat, and we could help them out by taking some of their kids on our buses. And, like, when their buses broke down, we just helped them, and when ours broke down, they helped us. So we got to really know them really well, and things just kind of cooked between us. We liked each other's shows, and that's all there is, you know. And a lot of people have boyfriends and girlfriends in Crossman, which is really nice.
Crossman, that's our favorite
color. Yeah, Crossman.
Sure, for people, they got the best people in the world.
They do.
They really helped us out a lot.
Of course, if it wasn't for them, we wouldn't be in this place right now.
Yeah, right. The wreck we all we had, you know.
Well, no, they started us off.
Today everybody felt like we played for the judges, you know, so it just wasn't there.
After tomorrow night, there will be no stands. They're all cave-in.
Right. Yeah, it's going to be great tomorrow night.
You know, a lot of people who aren't in Corps would like to be, you know, if they don't understand why, you get out and you work 14 hours a day just as hard as you can for one night in August.
For some Spirit of Atlanta members, tomorrow's performance will be their last. At 21, members must retire from active participation. Although many will remain involved in Drum Corps life, the personal and family relationships will end with tomorrow night's performance.
Tomorrow night can epitomize to me everything that we've done through all the cold weather, through all the being rained on, being baked in the sun, seeing our truck destroyed, all of the things that we've been through together as a family since November can be epitomized in one 13-minute performance tomorrow night. What I would like to see is every one of you do a show yourself that you enjoy to the utmost. And the dream that I had of a drum corps will be fulfilled totally, no matter what the placement. Now for tomorrow's schedule.
The first item on tomorrow's schedule? Roll up the sleeping bags. Waking up on cold gymnasium floors is not unusual. On the road this season, they've done it many times. Today begins like so many others, but everyone knows it certainly won't end the same. As corpsmen begin their familiar routine, thoughts are on tonight's competition. The maneuvers, the execution of techniques, the last chance to do it perfectly. Tonight's goal for the Spirit of Atlanta? To be judged one of the best drum corps in the world. They know they can do it. Maybe they didn't need to be told, but they heard it again last night.
The corps has the capacity for greatness. And think about what greatness means. Think about the great corps of drum corps history.